Sean Stasiak. Sean, thanks so much for being with us tonight.
Thanks for having me.
Sean, just how big a problem does professional wrestling have with steroids?
You know, everyone keeps asking that question, and I think you have to look at all professional sports and even athletes from all the way from high school through college is, you know, it's a very competitive business, no matter whether it's professional football, baseball, professional wrestling, MMA, whatever it may be. And I'm not pointing fingers at any particular profession, but, you know, there's a difference between use and abuse. And the problem with professional wrestling is that, you know, these guys are on the road 300 days a year. There's no off season. You're banging your body up. You're living in a hotel. You're traveling from one city to the next. You're flying all over the world, in fact. And, you know, we live in pain. And so, you know, I hear people talk about, well, it's not a real sport. It's not they're not real athletes. You know, there's been plenty of Olympic athletes, professional athletes that have tried to make it in professional wrestling and just couldn't quite cut it. It takes a very unique individual with a plethora of talents to be able to make it in that business.
Sean, just to cut to the chase on the question I asked, it sounds like the answer is yes, it does have a problem.
I believe that it can be a problem for some. I can't vouch for everybody. I know that everything affects, you know, you talk about, you know, substance affecting certain individuals. You have people that have one beer or one glass of wine and they freak out. You have people that could drink a six pack and be just fine and be happy. I think that goes with any substance, any drug, including anabolic steroids, is that, you know, there's thousands of athletes that have used steroids for many years but didn't freak out and kill
their
family.
But Sean, that obviously doesn't justify abusing these drugs. Maybe some people can take them better than others and can handle it better than others, but that doesn't justify abusing them. And the abuse seems to be widespread throughout professional wrestling.
Absolutely not. It doesn't justify that. I guess the rationale behind what I'm saying is that, you know, it's just like, you know, there's so many positions and these guys build their lives. That's how they pay their bills and support their families.
Sean, it sounds like you're justifying it.
I'll take that back. I'm not justifying anything, okay? There is obviously a problem with professional wrestling and wrestlers dropping off at early ages, okay? I believe that, you know, first and foremost, it's not anyone's fault. Vince McMahon or the WWE, he's
not
a babysitter.
Do they have a drug use policy or a steroid policy?
I've been away from the mainstream for about 5 years. I'm a doctor of chiropractic now, and I'm taking a whole different direction. But from my understanding from friends that were in the WWE, there's a pretty good drug testing policy. Apparently, they've sent guys that had problems to rehab to get them straight and get the help. But I just want to make this point. I believe that to move forward from all this negativity, I mean, it's just a horrific tragedy what happened. It's affected me. I didn't know Chris as well as a lot of these other guys, right, but I knew him well enough, and what everyone has said about him holds true. But this is just a horrific tragedy that's happened, and it's really affected me to the point that I've really thought, well, what can be done? And I think in the wrestling business, because there's no off seasons, I think what would really help a lot of the guys is to have off seasons, to be on the road 2 months.
So what responsibility does the WWE have to have policies, rules, schedules, or whatever that helps conform to a lifestyle that's healthier for the people who are working for the organization?
If I can just finish what I was saying, sir, I believe that if the WWE or any major wrestling federation could enforce a drug policy rule, if they're going to test one person, test everybody. There may be a financial issue there because it costs money to do that, but it's worth it. It's worth saving lives. And I think that, you know, to make an example out of one person and use that as a scapegoat, I think that's, you know, that's not right either. I think that if you have off seasons, if the guys are on the road 2-3 months in a row and then they get like a month off, they can heal their bodies, be with their families, save marriages, be with their kids, let their bodies heal, sleep in their own bed, eat their own food, and be able to recover, and maybe not have to rely on at all steroids or painkillers or anything of that nature. But the human body was just not meant to do
all right, Sean.
What we have done.
Sean, I have to leave it there. Thanks for joining us.